Welcome back to the channel. In a recent video, we walked you through the basics of Surrealist, which you can check out in the link below. Today, we're going to explore some of the power user features. Before we get started, in this video, we will use Surrealist desktop in a sandbox mode. Now let's get going. Surrealist ships some amazing tools to organize your connections. When we jump into the Surrealist settings, we can find a Templates tab. When we create a new template, we'll see that the UI is the same as when you create a new connection. We can fill in the details which we want our new connections to inherit, and leave empty the ones that we want to omit. Let's switch to the Connections dialog to try our new template. Press plus, New Connection, and then choose the newly created template. We can adjust what we need and then save the connection. If you are locally serving a database from Surrealist, this will show up as a template as well. When we press plus, we also have the ability to create a new connection group. We can change the name of the group by editing the title, and we can add connections to a group by editing them and selecting the desired group. Another cool feature in Surrealist is the ability to execute a portion of a query. Let's look at an example. If we highlight the select statement in this query, we will be able to execute just that portion. This is especially useful within large queries or when debugging one. Record IDs are a foundational piece of SurrealDB, as they represent a record of data. We wanted to do something with them in Surrealist, which is why we introduced the Record ID Inspector. You can access it via the Explorer view by opening a record, but you can also access it from any editor in Surrealist by pressing Ctrl or Command and clicking on a record ID. We can see the Record ID Inspector pop into view, allowing us to gain knowledge about that record on the fly. Let's quickly go over some editor shortcuts. You can use Control or Command plus Enter to execute a query, Tab to indent a line or selection, Shift plus Tab to dedent a line or selection, and Control or Command plus D to select the next occurrence of your current selection. If you want to quickly find something in Surrealist, be it a setting, a connection, a view, or anything else, you can do so with Surrealist Search. You can quickly access it anywhere by pressing Ctrl or Command plus K. We can start typing right away, and then navigate the menu with our arrow keys, and press Enter once we found the result that we need. Let's go over some useful settings. Editors in Surrealist show SurrealQL by default. However, sometimes you need JSON-compliant data. For this, we introduce the option to switch editors in Surrealist to show JSON instead of SurrealQL. By opening Surrealist settings and going to the Appearance section, we can change Value Formatting Mode to JSON. Popping back into our editor, we can see all results are now JSON. If you find yourself changing the result view constantly, you'll like this setting too. Also under the Appearance section, we can find the option to change the default result view. And lastly, depending on the queries and data you're working with, you may find it useful to change the query view's layout orientation. This will ensure the editor and result panels are stacked either under or besides each other. And that's it for this video. If you have any suggestions for power features you'd like to see introduced into Surrealist, feel free to let us know in the comments or by opening an issue on the Surrealist GitHub repository.